Well, in Challenger Series, C9T and Complexity were always close friends. And then eventually, when Broken Shard went to Israel for the visa, they approached me. I've always wanted to be in the LCS. It was my dream, and it feels good to be playing it. And I think the team is improving, slowly but surely.
An amazing but also difficult position to be in because there's shoes to fill.
Really interesting story there. But Kez, as was announced, is going to be the jungler for them for the foreseeable future.
That's right, and we're going to be started. Welcome back to the North American LCS right now. It is our next match of the day, Evil Geniuses versus Complexity. So far this split, these teams have seen the most roster instability, if you will. And for Complexity, it continues with the news that Broken Shard would be out again this week, and Kez would be continuing to play as the team's jungler now.
Yeah, and honestly, Kez has helped improve the team's focus on objectives and communication, it feels like. But really, Bubba Dubbed has been a bright spot for the team as well. Complexity's bottom lane, in general, has performed respectably against the other LCS teams in the early game. Bubba Dubbed and Argyx Lee, they've really been able to keep up with the best in the league and are one of the bright spots of Complexity.
Yep, and currently these two teams are tied for last place, and it's a sign of how tough the LCS has become that the team they're tied with has been beating some of the top teams.
Yeah, and Evil Geniuses want to prove that they're distinctly different from the bottom teams. While they did show some tremendous improvements early game with the addition of Helios, they didn't actually win any games last week. So this is a real test to see if their new lineup can take out a team that they would be considering a team they should beat, an easy win.
All right, well, let's get right into those lineups. On the blue side, it will be Evil Geniuses. In the top lane, it's going to be Inox, Helios in the jungle, Pobelter in mid, Altec at AD carry, and Krepo at support.
And on the red side, it is Complexity, with Westrise in the top lane, Kez in the jungle, Prawly in the mid lane, Robert Exley on AD, and Bubba Dub with Mustache on support.
So, yes, Evil Genius is coming in with a new jungler, but this is also the first time that EG has faced them as Broken Shard is out, and there was Mancloud last time. So there's two new people for the mid and the jungle on Complexity. It's almost like a whole new matchup here.
Yeah, we really just got to consider these guys have underwent a lot of change. I mean, EG had their first game of the split with Yellow Pete, and then that swap for Altec, then Snoopy swapped out right here for Helios, which is just a difficult thing to adapt to. They are in good spirits. They have been playing well. They just have to worry about, as we said, closing the games.
I think a very promising thing for Helios as well, before we switch over to Complexity, is that he's brought some aggression we've never seen as a first-time player. Nobody's really thrown themselves into the fire like that constantly to utilize plays for their team. Now, it didn't fully work out for them, but it has changed EG's early style of play.
Yeah, and it's a big step for Helios because you have to consider, he basically has to operate on keywords. His English is good, but he's not 100% fluent at the level that the guys that play League of Legends all the time and just scream reams of words at each other.
Absolutely.
Keyword shot calling back and forth between himself and Krepo and the rest of Evil Geniuses, and it's working quite well early game.
We'll see how it works in Champion Select as they chat about what they're going to be picking and banning. Looks like Cassidy will not be seen from game to game as we go into our fourth of the day, the Kale. Actually getting banned out. She's passed through and been able to pass through quite a bit today, but not this one.
Some teams valuing Kale really highly, other teams not at all. It's a little bit like Braum. We've been seeing some great starts, some terrible games.
Indeed.
But pretty high valuation percentage-wise, even combined the picks and the bans.
One more ban to go. Evil Genius is sneaking in a Jace.
Yeah, this is an interesting one.
Yes, it is.
It's some scouting that EG has been doing against old Prawly. It's the Annie pick used to be the old thing for Prawly, but maybe they've been doing some scouting onto this Jace. You would think it's a random ban, but EG doesn't do random bans.
No random bans. That's some homework being done there. The Evil Geniuses do mastermind a few things, and they put them to use when they need. Westrise looking at a Lulu to start this one off. The Inox already grabbed up for Pobelter, something he's seen almost trying to be taken away from him sometimes. He gets it this time, which guarantees a bit of wave clear to start off for EG's push.
And most importantly, they're taking it away from Prawly. So they really tried to do a number on him with this pick and ban phase. Getting rid of his Jace, knowing that his next favorite would be the Ziggs, and immediately taking it away from him. Pobelter as well has some great success on Ziggs in prior games, so great pick.
See what they can finish this one out. Westrise could be going for that Jax. Gives them safety towards the late game, something Complexity usually sees. They can always hold out into that portion of the game where they get the team fights. up and up. Robert Exley, if he gets going in the early game, we've seen it flourish to a defeat of Cloud9 if they can get him a few early kills in the bottom lane to make it right and make it so. Thresh and Lulu locked in as they pick up a little support play on the right side and a quick, very quick Twitch Morgana coming in.
Yeah, EG was ready for that. Complexity seemed a little hesitant because they swapped to both that Lulu and Thresh kind of in the last second of their champion selecting. The Lulu obviously is a flex pick, could go top or mid. The support's ruled out because we already have Thresh locked down for Complexity.
That would be Westrise's first Lulu. We've known him, the Malphites, the Mundos in the early part, Renekton, so that'd definitely be a different swap for him. Probably put some solo queue time on it, so it could work. We see a Hecarim being hovered as Complexity ponders what they can do. Not thinking about the Hecarim pick. It'd be quite an easy counter for Morgana to just bind you every day. We'll see what they got. Would love to see some Lux. A lot of the poke play came in. Nidalee's still available. No, she's not, actually, I should say.
Waiting until very late into the pick ban clock for Complexity to do things.
Whoa!
All right then, EG.
Yeah, all right then, indeed.
They have just done a lot of different stuff. So, Helios has played a lot of supportive jungle in Korea, especially when it was more in vogue. Jungle Nunu, especially right now, I think is coming back. With all the people building Sightstone on Elise, Nunu can build a Sightstone pretty much before any other jungler. He can go right from his Hunter's Machete into his Sightstone and get vision control. Top lane Rengar was also a thing before jungle Rengar was. So there's a good chance we see that Rengar top with the Nunu jungle, and they really try to wreak some havoc that way.
They still have his Jax up. It was hovered in the beginning. We still need that mid laner, so we can take the Lulu from Westrise. Very awesome pickups coming here for Evil Geniuses.
Really?
I love the fact that they go outside the box. We remember them for the Urgot Soraka as well with Yellow Pete and Krepo from that bottom lane kind of being the catalyst on what happens, but it may be a LeBlanc. That pressure play and the assassination possibility.
I mean, LeBlanc works against Ziggs, but definitely...
Right. Not
has some trouble with some early game trades. It's not the easiest matchup. It's very much Prawley's skills against Pobelto's skills and how frequently Helios can arrive into that lane. The Elise versus Nunu matchup in the jungle going to be a lot about control. Obviously, Elise does more damage, but can Nunu get it done?
It looks like Evil Geniuses have done a great job in bans here as well. The last time they played against Complexity, it was... Jax, Lee Sin, and Kassadin. So they switched the Jace out for that. Like you said, the homework's paying off. The other two bans they've already had going still fall into play. And Complexity and Evil Geniuses looking to get momentum here. Two teams at the bottom that need to start growing as well. They've got the positions in place for their players now. The rosters are set. And before the game gets underway, let's click over to lolesports.com and see who you've been voting for. 76% of the vote, you're calling it for Evil Geniuses coming into this game. Remember, you can continue to vote by tweeting EG win or call win. Like I said, these teams definitely need to start to get the momentum going from the bottom up.
Yeah, Complexity, they're the new guys, you know?
Yeah.
Even though EG has a lot of new elements to their team,
right,
they're actually the more experienced group of players.
Yeah.
Helios, he didn't come all the way over from Korea to finish 7th place on a North American LCS team, right? He needs and wants to do substantially better than they are doing right now. And EG was looking very good last week. The fact that they've had another week under their belt playing together, they've been doing a lot of work, obviously made some pretty decent-sized tweaks into their picks and bans. Let's see if it works out for them.
All right, we got to remember last time EG came out with a win in this match, so Complexity is kind of looking to get revenge in this as well. We've been saying both teams really... kind of new within the players they bought on the team. Like you said, EG does not want to finish 7th, and Helios kind of showed that out the gate when he started. He went for Inox. We'll see if he keeps going for Inox. It's changed from game to game. He's gone to Pobelter. EG is trying to use and facilitate that new jungler in different positions. We'll see what Complexity can do in this game as well. We saw the ban of Jace from Evil Geniuses to Complexity, so we'll see them going back to wheelhouse strategies. LeBlanc for that mid lane. But Westrise, his first play in the LCS on Lulu.
Yeah, well, he was the victim of Dyrus's Lulu in one
game. That's true, yep.
And didn't want to be the victim of that again. Westrise loves to play lane bullies. Like, he really likes to scrap in solo lanes. So Complexity would really want to get him a 1v1 matchup against Rengar. It's just a matter of will they be able to get that. I guess they know where they're at least initially positioned, but that doesn't mean much. These guys doing the five defensive line, probably group up and go for a late invade. But then it's all, so much of this is just guesswork. Picking up patterns of what teams have done previously, trying to figure out where they're going to go.
Not too many deep, deep wards placed in there. Helio's pushed off by Robert X. Lee, and you can see even the Nunu able to just heal himself up in the jungle. Also start with a ward. Sometimes we'll see that on other junglers, but it just goes to show that vision isn't going to come from that Nunu right from the start. We'll see how Helios plays it. We've seen No Name on it a few times to great effect.
It's interesting because Nunu actually doesn't stay super healthy if he does a full clear of sorts. Mm. He is going to be doing something a little bit creative right off the bat. He places his own ward at his red. I wonder if they're going to be trying to stop Kez when they go for the red steal, because what would be expected after this opening, especially if we do a lane swap, would be Helios going up. So they're going to maybe think about starting there. This is an interesting start.
I mean, without the lane swaps before, if you remember, Odd One did one time go red to red and kind of defy the whole jungle pattern.
Yeah.
It would be almost easier with more people on hand.
That's kind of what I would have expected. I'd expect Helios to try to go red to red right now.
Hmm.
But he didn't even start there. So what will they do?
Very interesting. Nox looks like they're going to buddy system it up. He says, wait up.
Oh, which would mean...
Maybe not.
Yeah, I mean, the reason Helios would put a ward at his own red is that he's hoping to catch Kez there. But they're going to be completely outnumbered if they do. Mm-hmm. So he'd have to do like a sneak attack with his smite and his consume and then flash out, because there's going to be more people there than they can deal with, unless he can take it super fast, which is what he's trying to do right now.
This could be a scary situation. Probably already pushed up Poebelter. He may not be able to leave lane as soon. But no, it's the dragon. I thought Complexity was going to start heading into the jungle. But they stop. All right.
They did the one buff dragon. Mm-hmm. So at the end of the day, they all choose their level one paths. Nunu doesn't get any actual counter jungling down. And this swapping isn't as clean as other teams have been. And the Nunu has arrived.
This is going to be big. Depending on what Helios took. It doesn't look like they actually want enough, but stopping the dragon is good enough. Brawly, Krepo is going to take a lot of damage on this one, but actually cannot with Poebelter just on his heels. Brawly keeps it safe and doesn't tunnel in on the kill.
I feel like stopping that dragon was huge in so many ways. So EG outplaying that mind game. Obviously a little bit of ward control, but then to just go down there and check. We said when all these teams were taking the 3-minute, 3-minute, 30-second dragon, they have to do so much dancing, and everyone has to 100% be on damage. As soon as you put any type of disruption into that, it just crumbles away. And Helios just had to look at him. They had to get off of it.
Very great play. Poebelter run towards the danger to sometimes dodge out of it. Very nicely played. Calm, cool, and collected. Didn't even have to flash.
Not at all. Right there. So Poebelter, 18 CS to 18 CS of Prawly, but getting the clone out is actually pretty key considering he is the one who got ganked.
Yeah. His kill pressure is also down on Prawly's side. That ignite is out. Oh, close. Westrice dodges the bindings as well. Everybody, good eyes today and getting out of those skill shots. The freeze lane, though. Altec's not making this easy. Westrice is just going to be hanging out.
Yeah, and Westrice already down a flash in that lane. So something bad happened right at the start. Most likely it landed binding somewhere from Krepo.
Oh, blowing the flash. Even Prawly gave Poebelter credit on that throw. He knew it was going to be big danger. Not too much follow-up on that after the Tormented Soil, but EG is doing great in all lanes right now.
Yeah, these 1v2 lanes are not working this time for Complexity, because honestly, Kez took so much damage early at that dragon, and normally you'd expect the team with the 80 carry support bottom to have an edge because of that dragon. Not the case in this one.
Yeah, when's the last time you saw the jungler come up just to help the top laner by himself? That means it's going to be Helios soaking up all that solo experience in the jungle by himself, and Enox can be down there 1v1ing on Robert X. Lee. EG getting everything they want to play out here in this early game, and the Sight Stone's already built on Helios.
Yeah, it'll be very important to see how Inox can track his power. He needs to get a lot of Doran plays early. That's the typical Rengar thing. I wonder if he's going to be going a more defensive kind of tank Rengar, or if he's going to be going with the full damage Rengar who tries to jump in and instantly kill an AD carry. It's not as good as it was since they've done the change to make the critical strikes of his first Q not crit the bonus damage like it was. It's only critting off the base like most spells.
See how Inox plays it. If he gets a few kills early, he may just change his mind and go for that damage as well. We always know he loves to be the carry, and EG will let him be in that position. Helios, the aggression once again. Actually, level 4 to level 5 Kez, but he will still be able to put up a fight in that jungle. The early aggression from Helios, we saw kind of the communication thwart that jungle. So EG's mind is in the right spot to the start of this game.
You're really just waiting for the first move. I can see already that Helios has a Sight Stone, right? That's what we're kind of tracking. Whereas Kez has built a lot of wards and he's got a Spirit Stone, but the question will be, how many deep wards can Helios get, and how is that going to inform EG's decisions? Because this is kind of the moment where you want to start getting that control for your team as a new jungle.
Well, it's only going to get easier if you have Pole Belter throwing probably into his turret all the time. The Pole Belter can roam. You can get the alts coming out. Helios has a lot of free roam as well with the range of that. He's not making too many moves just yet. He's in the bottom lane right now trying to help it out. Pole Belter having his way right now in the mid lane. Credit to Prolly for keeping that CS though in a Ziggs LeBlanc lane.
Yeah. The LeBlanc not having any time to roam is another big thing.
Mm-hmm.
Surprisingly, with these 2v1s happening, the ones are having pretty good CS. 28 for Inox, because there's been a lot of 1v1. It's not just the 2v1. That bodes well for the Rengar, hitting level 6 and potentially pulling off a mid lane gank at some point.
Probably you can see him just in and out peppering the damage. He knows he can't stay in the fight for long. Gonna get this blue buff so he can. Get some of those ethereal chains out so he can get some damage down. Hasn't really even tried to go onto Pole Belter. With that Ignite being back up, maybe he may be able to get a kill in. Look at the AD carry, 65 to 60 there. They're not going to be meeting up anytime soon. We actually haven't had too much aggression on the turrets. So this game, even though it's not standard lanes, it's still going quite slow.
Yeah, and the timer's off there for EG. I don't know why they expected the red to be up at that time, because they were contesting the dragon while Kez didn't have a red buff. But they get the ward nonetheless. So some pretty big miscommunication there, all things considered, for EG. They needed that timing to work out, because they went up there for a red steal, whereas Complexity just going for the drag.
Wow, that almost went very good in the top lane. No Name was going to go, or Helios, I should say, going for a kill. See Nunu, see No Name. It's going to be an easy dragon for Complexity. That's the first gold lead we're seeing, and this has to be a very careful Westrice in the top lane at level 4 here. He almost got taken out by Helios, but he decided to back off and help Pole Belter with blue.
Yeah, and obviously EG has the timer on the red buff now.
Yeah.
But it cost them the dragon. It's just a... I can't emphasize enough how bad that was by EG, or just how much that puts them behind their initial plans, because the Nunu wants to out-control and get buff control, and because of a missed timer, they just lost it. Or not even a missed timer, just something they weren't paying close attention to.
Didn't get anything out of the top roam. Helios and the rest of the team looking to get a new priority in order after the dragon goes down.
Yeah. It's really... really about cycling their objectives right here, and EG doesn't have much to cycle back for. They know the dragon is down, they've lost vision control as well, which makes it more dangerous to go into that spot. Helios has fallen behind.
Yeah, quite a bit now, 32 to 23.
Really, they're losing their interior pink ward control right now, which is really unfortunate.
This is the slow, tough loss of vision, loss of control over the game. Everybody has to react on something, and right now Complexity does seem to be a little bit in the driver's seat. Good damage from Westrice. Kez looks like he also wants to put pressure here, and there's no counter as well. Helios on the bottom side of the map for this one, so they're gonna get what they want.
Yeah, and Pope Elther's doing quite a good job on blue. They're hooked onto Altec.
What a
he
great
is so
crap.
Low.
What a great Soul Shackle as well. Pulled in for the rest of the damage. Robert X. Lee throws down the Relentless Pursuit. He should have the finisher.
Wow.
They trade it back and forth. This may have been a mistake. Krepo's now ready to go on this one. Altec turns for the last shot. Keeps himself alive.
EG bottom lane completely on their own accord, pulling off that kill. And then the Gankman!
It's going to be right on up Raleigh. Gets the great Bolo! He goes back to the distortion point. That actually forces a flash there. No distortion. Inox able to finish it out, but they use quite a bit in that fight. Coming out with 3 kills, though.
Yeah, and just like that, they make up for the missed timers. And it had nothing
what
to do with the jungle. It was all about Altec and Krepo. This time, it's really the fear of Morgana and how strong her zone control can be.
That dodge.
Robert and Altec. And obviously the dodging from Altec right here was huge. But then Altec opening at the right moment, once no damage had really been put down onto Crepo when it should have been. As Twitch was going away is when they needed to kill Morgana.
Oh my god, it doesn't stop. Jap, Pobelter now could be the focus here. Trying to put himself in between. Inox gives himself enough space with Pobelter. Oh, great ball! Oh my gosh, what a save! EG's mid laner gets out by the skin of his teeth.
Complexity's got to be getting real frustrated right now because that's two kills that just barely slipped away from them.
Some of the easiest situations to create tunneling, Jack. They can want more and more next time and continue to a dangerous position.
Especially from a Complexity team who early in the season just tried to make play after play. The flash just for the slow onto Westrice. It's hard to get away from Nunu.
Look, he's going to get all the auto attacks in, too, to just keep these free spells coming in. It's not even going to cost them anything. The red buff is there as well. It is just useless to try and run.
Yep, great timing there by Helios. Knowing with the red buff, even if Westrice had his flash up, there was no escape. He was pushed too deep in enemy territory.
The pink wards are starting to come out as well in all the inventories. There's the... There's a little plus to having a Ziggs on your team as well. You can clear out a lane without being there, but Pobelter's still going to have to make a long walk down as his team holds pressure in mid for him.
Yeah, the fact that they're up 4-0 now, they kind of just turned it on. And that was mainly about the performance by Altec and Crepo on the bottom lane, their ever-growing synergy together. They lock in that Twitch real early, and now Altec is just on the hunt for stuff.
Get himself a little bit. Inox, good guy Inox, diving right in front of the death sentence, and he tries to write off on that one. It's going to help Altec maximum. 4-0 for him. He's only not participated in one kill on the map. It's pretty damn good.
And getting an assistless Twitch when he's getting all those kills is even better. The gold distribution is pretty much ideal for EG right now, especially because they have the Blood Boil to buff him up late game. But yeah, this is what Complexity saw at the start of it, just a Twitch out of nowhere, and they didn't really know where anyone else was going to be. Inox, Helios, they all collapsed at the end and made Complexity have to back up after Kez had already engaged. Based on the knowledge they had, they wanted to get that, and very quickly, Kez needs to pick up that sidestep.
Mouse bait everywhere. Inox going invisible, and Altec just staying in the eyeline the whole time, and Complexity thinking they have the upper hand, but they lose their blue there, showing them that they do not. EG starts to move in a little bit harder, a 2v1 situation, really playing himself inside the minions. The binding hits, as well as the Mega Inferno Bomb, and Complexity can't even look at EG.
Altec is taking over this game right now, 5-0-0. He's 6,000 gold, which is 2,000 ahead of what Robert X. Lee has right now. All off of those two kills. You cannot afford to die 2v2 at this level.
Altec really showing his prowess within these games and coming out of laning phase a lot stronger than usual as well. Usually these are the kills that come for him in the fighting phase, but he got a few of that cash money buildup right out of lane, now finalizing a few kills and even 2v1s for himself. It's looking grim right now for Complexity, but the game is not over. Inhibitor spirits are still up.
You can really feel like EG is in sync right now.
Right.
They got the kills, they went up, found control in the top, got the kill. They realized the dragon would be respawned. Got control in mid lane. After that, they could get control in the blue buff jungle as the dragon was coming up. Everything is working in synchrony for EG right now. The question will become, can they close?
Can they
close? Because they've been up in their last two games, early game as well.
That is actually a pretty scary thought. Hadn't thought of it till now. Up in gold, not able to get the game finished out. Sometimes when they're down in gold, they're able to win fights that seem unwinnable. But it's just the flip side. Every time they get to that climax, they got to be able to end it. 134 to 123 as we look at the mid lane. Prolly is falling behind a bit there on Pobelter, which would be expected. And we also haven't seen Roam out of these guys yet. Something Prolly usually has a hand in the middle of the game, getting his team going, getting kills. You see the momentum of Prolly carry everybody.
Yeah, and we can also see Inox going for the tank build. So if Prolly does get going, he can kind of bypass that tank Rengar.
Right.
Go for the damage dealers and maybe cut out EG because they're very much going for that classic old school two threat team with Ziggs and Twitch being the only big damage dealers, at least for the next 20 so minutes of the game.
We'll see how good at Complexity is at putting up the brick wall versus Evil Geniuses. So far, they haven't really gotten too much sieging onto turrets. They're fine with clearing out these waves and then backing off. Pobelter with the blue, they're not utilizing it. A ton of pink wards just kind of hovering the bottom side, but everything's kind of waited to be moved forward right now. This doesn't seem like EG has any priorities.
It's so hard for Complexity to move forward, though.
That's true.
Against a Twitch. EG, it's a little difficult. It's still very early. They probably just want to control the buffs as they respawn for Complexity and then the dragon again, because they have a bit of a stranglehold, but they got it so early this time. They just need to kind of starve out the mini objectives before going for the big ones.
It's kind of like getting that second tier turret, and everybody's like, slow down.
Yeah.
We actually didn't have enough gold to go there.
They already got a second.
Working out quite well for them. Even when we saw him get that dragon just recently, Inox had no trouble being in the top lane. EG has great control over the map right now, and you can see using it to full extent. Already see that Pobelter, or rather Prolly, is just hanging out on the wing, but this could be a very assassinated Krepo. The shield comes out. That lockdown actually does hit because of the Q coming out. Very nice sigil hit. Nothing to follow, though.
The power of his black shield right there, and Prolly didn't all in for that one little landed chain. And meanwhile, while Complexity was laying that trap, their other lanes were pushing up, so they now have to go back and clean up what EG had been able to pull off while they were gone. But they continue the three-man push down bottom. They could get jumped again.
They get Altec. Oh my gosh, what a grab! They thread the needle, but he's out and in the back of the fight. Altec is fighting with 2,000 gold in his pocket right now.
Oh, wow.
I cannot believe EG is still coming out on top of these fights.
They just got a 2-0. In a 3v4 where they got engaged on. This game,
AD carry first,
feels over. That was pretty much as good of a catch as Complexity's gonna get, and they got wrecked.
It has to be ticking against them. Every time they try something, the call is negated by Evil Geniuses. The perfect grab onto the AD carry, and it, nothing can be had from it.
I mean,
8-0.
We know the way EG was feeling coming into this game. Like, they wanted to distinguish themselves as a much better team in the North American LCS, and they are doing so right now. This is a statement game at this point. 8-0, 17 minutes in. And let's just watch this fight one more time. Altec gets jumped on, but then the Black Shield stops the chain crowd control, and then he gets far enough back that he can open. That's the other great thing about the Nunu. The Absolute Zero, right as they're trying to dive through, not everyone could actually get onto him, and the threats were all distorted as far as where they were going. Altec didn't get touched, now he's got a Ghostblade.
Becomes such a tough game when everything you think that's in your favor quickly just goes in the enemy's favor. Yep. So hard to start making calls. Complexity seems to still be keeping the communication up, though. They're still keeping the wards out, doing everything they can to get that one pick that could really slate them back into this game. But they're so far behind, just Tabi's and a Sight Stone right now onto Kez.
Yeah.
It's hard to fight.
He never even made it to a Spirit of the Ancient Golem.
No.
Which is something most Elises make to before they do anything else. He knew he needed to compete with the Sightstone of Nunu, but now he's just so far behind in items. Complexity can't even get the mid lane. Their side lanes are in big trouble right now. EG's going to continue their push.
They're trying to open up the map, at least get some of that gold back, Jap, but you can see how quickly they are dictated by Evil Genius's movements. Instantly back, and they got to go the long way, because this turret already is not safe to guard at 19 minutes.
Yeah, all things must go through Nunu at this point if they want to get anywhere. And Helios is a very strong looking frontliner there. Pobelter gets a little bit hooked in, but that's just to open up Twitch.
That was quite scary. He gets a nice rat-a-tat-tat from the center line of the fight. Shreds through Bubba Dub. Can't really get an initiation for himself. And everybody's just slowing down. Inox hasn't even really been with the team this game, but he's 1-0-1, playing his own style.
Yeah, he's just the guy who takes lanes off on the side. He's going to be one of those late-game tank Rengars who would build enough damage to be able to threaten the AD carry, but not the squishy guy that can really fall behind. That's actually the type of Rengar we saw a lot in competitive play before he was disabled for so long, was this Sunfire Cape tank utility Rengar. He's almost impossible to push out of lane, and he still makes a stealth impact in team fights.
Probably trying to make plays. Doesn't have too much vision on the rest of that. Just to clear out a pink ward. Still waiting to see what Evil Geniuses can do. We're only 20 minutes into the game. EG has made their way to the front base, but now can they end it? It's been the question in a lot of their games that they've played. It just seems to stall out at the end portion of the game, right here when they get to the front side of the base. And to see West Rice, Prowley, and Robert Exley, they have a bit of clear. You can get that out with impact. But they shouldn't be able to stop a Pobelter right now, especially with Helios being so far ahead. The dive should be there for EG.
Yeah. 8,000 gold to 20 minutes.
It's pretty big.
pretty big.
The Yomu's coming out onto Altec. He just wants to keep throwing out the pain, a little bit of the penetration as well. Helios and team going to grab up the dragon. No real reason to even chance anything at Baron. They have so much control of the game that it would almost be a risk to try and get that last fight they want.
Yeah, they don't need to force Baron as of yet.
Right.
They definitely want to probably reach their next item breakpoint before doing anything huge. Or maybe just get a pick somewhere, because Inox still has that pick potential on Rengar. He can jump in with an empowered bowl and get a catch on someone if they really need it. They don't quite need it right now. They're just powering up across the board.
Plexi's going to power up as well. Got to be careful on EG's side. It's going to take a while. Got about 10 minutes of powering up necessary for Complexity if there's no good fight in between. But being able to clear out these lanes, it's almost like EG has not approached any of these inhibitor turrets. They don't feel they're strong enough, or that they're just looking for too good of a catch that they may not get. And that could be what falls them into their stall out.
Yeah, I mean, Altec's sitting on 1,800 gold as well.
Mm-hmm.
So do they have to wait for him to go back and shop before they make a big move? Like, how willing are they to commit kind of right now whenever they see a window? They need to make sure they don't get too patient and give up their map pressure. So it's good to see them, even with gold in their pockets, actually making aggressive plays right now.
Oh, I like this. The ward clearing will get your...
Oh
baby! That's gonna... Oh, no! He saves him! It's burning! It's so hot! Oh, he's on fire! Hobelter huffing a bomb over his shoulder. 28 seconds on Robert X. Lee. It's around 30 per death right now. I don't know if it's enough to really pressure too much, but EG does need to move here.
Well, Altec with the Scrying Orb actually has them land some damage on a Kez, and they know where Restrice is. They want to at least burn the teleport, and they know that Robert is down. Plus, the Nunu Secure is some of the best Baron securing tools they can get.
Oh, dear. At least still alive. We're going to have to be very careful for Kez. The Vision Denial is there. Kind of guessing where it is. Can't kill a Lantern. Not going to help. Kez, doesn't go up. 1,900 HP on the Baron. 1,500. It's going to be the Snipe. Smite and Sue coming in from Helios. And they are going to be on the run. Inox is actually called back from the team. Good control. Jumps over the wall with the Vision. They find Westrice. Oh, no. He jumps into Inox and he uses everything. Still going down.
11-0 right there. And that's a bold call by Helios. Yes, the consume helps the Nunu, but you actually don't rank it that much, so it is an extra 400 true damage to go along with the 680 from his spite. So still a little bit risky, but a very secure move there by EG.
What a controlled game so far, Jat. Almost 24 minutes in, we're getting the first inhibitor down for Complexity. 7 turrets in total for EG that they've taken off the map, and they're only going to be looking for more here. Top lane's ready for a push.
Yeah. I mean, how much gold are they sitting on now? It's the real question. 3,300 for Altec. They're going to try and keep their pressure up because they have a big experience advantage here too. But if they go back to shop, that's probably the last trip home they make this game because they go so far ahead and they will be so much more powerful after they shop.
It's absolutely amazing to see the AD carry have one of the highest levels in the game. 3 levels over Prowly right now. That's why he's never going back. He just has the damage. Absolute Zero shredding back Complexity, I should say, disengaging them from the fight.
All things told, EG's actually sitting on about 10,000 unspent gold right here.
Oh no! Altec gets grabbed! Could have been some defense and he needed there. A great rebuttal back with the bomb. It's going to be some damage, but only to the clone. Thought probably went down. It was a joke.
Yeah, the perfect game is denied. And honestly, EG overreached a little bit there. They're feeling so damn confident and so many things had worked in a row that they overstayed. But having 10,000 unspent gold when they have a 12,000 gold lead means they're pretty much just fighting with the experience bonus and the Baron buff, which is a lot, but not enough to just try and twitch siege outside a turret. He's not a good sieger, and he got hooked.
What a game still for Evil Geniuses. We talked that they had a little bit of error room to work with in minutes. That was one of them right there. But you see Polebelter 227 to 162 on Prowly. 0-2-1 there to 1-0-2. A lot of that just across the board. Still waiting for really Inox to have a huge impact in these fights. We've seen a few plays with him.
Surprise.
Uh-oh. This is EG having the vision all around the map, having control of the map as well. Prowly considering whether he can help. Complexity isn't initiating anything right now. They're being scared and trying to assess what EG's doing. That's not how you get back to the game.
Yeah, they were hoping to catch a random dragon spawn to kind of slingshot their experience and gold back a little in this game, but it was not to be. And we saw that a couple times this game. It's really swung in a few ways. Once Nunu gets you with the one ice ball, If you're not ahead in the game or willing to fight him, you're going to die.
Over and over. And Helios coming out playing a really strong Nunu. 0-0-6, you couldn't ask for more just to have assists on the jungler. Snowballing your team, no pun intended, all the way through the game. I had to for Freak. 12-1 here, 26 minutes in, and we're still looking at that 12,000 gold lead.
Yep, and this time Twitch built an Infinity Edge. So he is an Infinity Edge stronger than he was. Look at that guy.
Wow, he can take a beating already too. Aegis built up for his team. Inox pushing the bottom lane. He saw in a quick camera switch. Robert X Lee, half health from the Mega Inferno Bomb. But still, a bit of the wave here coming out. They're able to get it with the piercing lights. Oh, very close. Probably not taking too much damage on that.
Pull both of the blue buff is very important for him right now. There is an open entrance to the base if Inox wanted to make it in for the next push, but that would also create the 5v5. EG, not a very good sieging team, we mentioned. They do not want to have Altec get hooked like he did last time. But at the same time,
there's Baron off.
I don't think EG's going to mess around. I think they're going on the next wave.
So Baron has been waited out from Complexity. Helios really has to consider his engagements in this. He can be flayed out, he can be silenced instantly. Locked up by Kez or somebody else. The Scrying Orb is down.
Orb.
There's the safety. You're going to see Altec on the top side of the turret so he can stay safe for a few shots. They're really putting the pressure on. They are worried about the damage that Complexity can do. Sometimes you just got to go headstrong and have it. Take the turret down. Finally, doing a bit of extra damage to Helios there. And they're still scrambling. Now for the inhibitor, Jat. We'll see if Complexity can hold this off.
Yeah, this is going to be a lot harder because of the aforementioned gold lead.
Yep. There's a 1-2. You can see it almost doesn't even impact the health bar of Polebrother right now. Probably so far behind, just the ability tome on top of an Athene's, not something that a LeBlanc is going to assassinate you with.
A good amount of poke by Polebrother getting Complexity pretty low. And Inox, he's coming in for this fight.
Dun-dun-dun-dun from the bottom side. He dives into a minion, almost gets the minion gold. He was actually going for Kez after that one. The inhibitor goes down, and it looks like Twitch will finally take down Prowly. He won't be able to really change anybody's mind about this fight with a burst of damage. And it looks like the second inhibitor will fall too.
Yeah.
They're going around the horn on this one.
It's only a matter of time. Inox, good leap. They got two inhibs.
That was a great leap.
Yeah, so everything worked out better than expected. EG 13-1, 13,000 gold lead, and really just dominating. They do have that two threat team, and they are taking this a little bit slow when you consider their overall gold lead. When you consider it in the context of a normal game, we're 28 minutes in. This is still a fast game.
It absolutely is. Almost should be faster. Let me take a look at this one more time. It could have been the end.
Oh, wow. That was really clever. Altec threw his poison out after Prowly jumped away, knowing he was going to come back immediately. There was just no escape.
Nice try. Yeah. Too bad, so sad. 13-1. That one death still lingering. I'm sure Altec is just thinking about it the whole time here. Will be when he goes to bed tonight. 8-3 in turrets, and they have just opened up this map of Complexities like a Christmas present. They're ready for the bottom side now. They're ready for the last present under the tree. It's going to be a Nexus, and really, EG has had it for quite a while. Looking across the board, everybody has the kills that they need, and to have them keep going to Altec, really, EG, I think, starts to play in his favor, or to his favor, knowing that he can be someone that will carry in the late game. They actually put that into motion.
Especially with this team composition. You know, the Nunu jungle, the tank, Rengar, a lot of it is dependent on whether or not Altec can get going in a big way.
Krepo, too, very big with the Zhonya's being finished up. They have so many possibilities and so many things that could go wrong in the fight where they just make it right again. That's going to be a quick kill, actually. That's how big Altec
that
is right now.
One or two crits in the backside and Prowly disappeared.
Faster than the blink of an eye. 9-1-3 on the game right now, almost hitting that 10-pointer. Fantasy players are quite happy with Altec this weekend. It's going to be on the inhibitor turret. The rappel is up, and they're on to Polebrother. A good bit of damage, but he already gets his ult off. That's really all that needs to happen if he goes down. But he's still alive. All of EGR as they continue the fight. The red buff burns up Polebrother, but he gets a heal there from the summoner heal. They're on to the Nexus turret, and just in 30 minutes, Evil Geniuses comes out with a Nunu composition to take down Complexity, 18-1.
Yeah, that has to feel good for Evil Geniuses right there because they just dominated the most one-sided victory that we saw today. Hugs all around for EG because they deserve it.
What a fantastic game. Altec and Krepo in the bottom lane coming up huge. during some ganks, and then again during some more ganks. Altec being hooked out in a 3v1 fight, repositions with the help of Krepo's Black Shield. Again, there's those two names again. Krepo and Altec, they played amazing this game, and Helios brought out a new play style as well. EG definitely came together here.
Yeah, Altec 11-1-4. Just saying, he's only started in 15% of fantasy leagues right now, so people need to start starting this guy because he is going to be putting up numbers. Definitely a young, really good AD carry in the North American LCS.
Absolutely. That wasn't a Corki game, and he does the same thing on Corki. Not a one champion wonder. Altec's definitely someone to be reckoned with. The bottom lane as well. Complexity still seeing some struggles as they come in. This roster is now locked in. That's the time that they still have to kind of bolster themselves. Teams like TSM, teams like CLG, when they got their new roster, it said it would take time, and the same thing for Complexity.
Yeah, it takes time for everyone. I mean, Complexity, you can argue, has just as new of a roster as EG.
Right.
And when Pez came in, he made a very big impact. But this game, he just fell behind. He had to build that Sightstone before he was ready to finish his items, got behind on gold. He got let down a little bit by his bottom lane as well. We called them out in the pregame for performing well. Bubba Dub and Robert X Lee cannot afford to die in a 2v2 situation because that Twitch really took over the game.
Right, all right. Right now we are going to send it down to Kobe for a quick interview on the blue side.
Thank you, Riv. I'm here with Krepo after their win and Inox in the background. Now, you guys, you start out with this Nunu pick. Not a lot of North American teams do this. You were able to stop the first dragon. However, the second buff spawns, I think you guys guessed wrong, not able to control it. Did you get everything that you wanted out of this Nunu pick?
We knew we were going to get targeted in the jungle, or possibly, so we had to work on alternatives this weekend. So we just don't stick to the Lee Sin and the Elise while we can still play them perfectly fine there, TSM fans. We just went for something else. It worked out. We had to make sure they didn't do the early dragon. We scaled into the late game really well. We just made sure whatever we contested was safe because we knew we had the better lane and the better teamwork. That's what we've been working on a lot this week. And yeah, it worked out. Really sad that Altec's the feeder with 100% death participation, but he did his best.
I was going to say, speaking about teamwork, you guys in the bottom lane, you and Altec really seem to have improved a lot. You got your 2v2 double kill down there. What is it like working with Altec now? How far have you guys come, and do you still have a lot of room to make up?
We still have a long time to go, honestly. Like right there, his ulti was down before, so I was under the assumption he was still down. So I actually flashed out a little too early, thinking I'd just sacrifice myself and get him out of there. But then he popped his ulti and just decided to 1v2 them, and I was like, all right, Johnny boy, you do that. I'll just sit here and watch. Yeah, he's just a really good player. Really good mechanics. He's getting a lot better at the things he has to improve on. So we told him, like, improve on your picks. And you saw it. You just, at the end of the game, all we hear in voice chat is like, yeah, I'm going to go for this kill right now. And it works.
Now, we also want to know about the overall team communication because you guys brought in Helios, another guy who speaks another language. CLG have been working with similar situation. How is it right now for your team with shot calling? And what is the ideal situation for how shot calling will work within your team?
We had some issues with it, mostly because not only Helios, but other members were just playing the game but not talking as much. And in reactions with that, I ended up talking more to try and fill that void. But in the end, what you end up doing is just you drown them out even more. So you need to make sure like you identify, hey, Krepo, you're talking too much. Teammates, you're talking too little. Let's meet in the middle. And then with a foreign jungler, it gets tricky. But if we speak to like core words, you say like blue buff invade, contest, we make sure we understand the words that we use. And then it's fine with Dongjin as well. He calls a lot of shots. He says vision, lane push, go for towers. Like we understand each other perfectly enough to play League of Legends. And it's been going well.
Do you guys specifically separate people into people who are going to add information to the pool and then people who are going to take that information and make calls? Or is it kind of everybody's trying to add information?
We just want to make sure that whatever happens, a play is set up. Something has to be called. Like, what are we doing next in this game? It doesn't matter if Tyson says that or Eugene or whoever, like me or even like jungler. As long as that's set up, and as you just have to focus on your own game, feed as much information from your side, and then as a collective, you can make that calls. But mostly, it's right now the jungler making like the strategic like map movements, and I'm filling in a little bit because I don't have as much to do on the map as a support compared to carries. And yeah, we're finding something that works, and it's getting better every time.
Well, it definitely worked this game. Congratulations again, Krepo. Now we are going to send it back up to the guys at the desk.
Thanks, Kobe, and let's see how the table is set after our day on the Rift. And first, we have CLG and Dignitas. Then one game back, it's another tie with Cloud9 and LMQ in third.
And alone in fifth is TSM, tied for sixth are Evil Geniuses and Team Curse, with Complexity holding last place with two wins.
We'll be back tomorrow starting at 9 a.m. with the European Challenger Series Best of Three battle between Gamers2 and Lublin Shore. Then the North American LCS kicks off with four more matches to six. To help your League of Legends thirst.
Starting with Dignitas versus Complexity. Then TSM will battle Evil Geniuses, followed by CLG taking on Curse.
And we'll conclude our day with Cloud9 versus LMQ. The action kicks off Friday, 9 a.m. Pacific time, 6 p.m. Central European Summer time. But now we're going to pass the torch to Freakin' Zyrene for the North American Challenger Series. On the way, let's take one last look at today's action.
Feel the rain on your skin. No one else can feel
I'm
it
starting.
For you.
Stop throwing.
Okay.
Can he get enough there? Lemonation is low. One hit from Dan. They can't quite find it. There we go. Jinx is excited. Balls goes down. Boss falls as well. But can they get high? They've got to be careful. Zap. Going to get flashed away.
Oh! Oh,
dodging. Go cut. Damn it.
Oh, no.
Did anyone drop their Doritos?
They would not like to give up two turrets for one.
Pop the ulti, big damage comes through. Shockwave hits on three. Cubic goes down, though. They're going to have to back on the lead. One for one so far. Crest watch it. He keeps it.
Oh, God! Oh, God! Oh, God!
I see you for that.
He's just getting deleted for an Afro move. A three-person bump breaker. Wow! Coming in huge. Shocking off of Counter Logic Gaming.
I decide what the tide will bring.
Robert X Lee throws down the Relentless Pursuit. He should have the finisher.
Wow.
They trade it back and forth. This may have been a mistake. Krepo's now ready to go on this one. Altec turns for the last shot.
Oh,
baby. That's going to... Oh, he saves him. It's burning.
Oh!